Hello and thanks for joining us. I'm Laurel Hess and this is Comcast Newsmakers coming to you from the Detroit Regional Chamber Mackinac Policy Conference being taped at the Grand Hotel. Our topic today is investing in Detroit. Joining us now to talk about it is Andra Rush, the CEO of Detroit Manufacturing Systems. Thank you so much for joining us today.
I'm happy to be here.
Talking about investing in Detroit, because you actually recently announced this new business, Detroit Manufacturing Systems, that is beginning production in August. And so a brand new business bringing brand new jobs and producing brand new stuff in the city of Detroit.
Yeah, I'm so excited. It's great opportunity for us to engage with Detroit and stay in Michigan and participate in the economic recovery of Detroit and our state. And we have great momentum, and it's been a dream of mine to create opportunity in underserved communities. My grandmother grew up on a Native American reservation in Canada, and I had always hoped that I would someday be able to give back to our community and other communities that aren't as fortunate. So this opportunity came about as a result of the leadership of Ford Motor Company and a joint venture with Rush Group Limited and Forcia, which is a $22 billion company located worldwide in Nanterre, France.
And so what exactly will Detroit Manufacturing Systems be creating and making, and how many approximate jobs will it be creating in the city?
Oh, that's what's really exciting. We're going to create the cockpit for the top seven brands of Ford Motor, starting with the Mustang, Expedition, Navigator, and then going to the crown jewel, the F-150, as well as the Focus and also the Edge and Escape. And not only the cockpit, but the doors and the center console will make substrates as well as component parts. The jobs, that's the real exciting part. The jobs we're creating initially will be 500, which we hope to achieve full employment probably April 2013. And some of our employees, I just had a chance to greet, I think we're at 41 employees right now, and I had a chance to greet our team members yesterday, and they were like, this is my first job in 5 years. How long are you staying?
Well, and if you're only at 41 and you're trying to get to 500, you must have job openings.
Yes, we do. We have a cadence on how we're going to bring the jobs on, but certainly we are going to have job fairs, and we are reaching out with local media at the times and places that we are hiring. But it's been ongoing since February.
All we keep hearing is that manufacturing is dying. It's no more. You know, what's there might be there, but we're not going to grow it. We're not going to worry about it. We need to diversify. We need to get into other sectors. How are you able to sort of come out of, the city of Detroit and create a brand new manufacturing automotive supplier, if you will?
Well, I think I've heard that rhetoric before, but I believe that the pillar industry is manufacturing, and all service industries are anchored by manufacturing. And if a country loses manufacturing, it loses its direction and base. So I think, contrary to what we've been hearing lately, manufacturing is going to be a key initiative for our nation and certainly for the state of Michigan. And I've been a supplier to the auto industry for over 28 years, primarily for GM, Chrysler, but also Toyota, Honda. And it's been just a collaboration among all three, with Ford taking the lead on this opportunity and finding a win-win-win, not only for minority business enterprise, but the city of Detroit and Ford Motor Company.
Well, it is nice to see is the manufacturing facility going to be based in the city proper?
Yes, it is. So we're excited about that.
So great investment in the city, investing in certainly the residents of the city, and keeping manufacturing in our great state, which, the great debate. And I do hear a lot of people as well say that it's not going away. So proving it to be true. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
Today's Comcast Newsmaker was Andra Rush, the CEO of Detroit Manufacturing Systems.